What is about the first chapter? Arrival of the Europeans in India. So it is about history. Now, today we are going to start our second chapter, which is from the geography section. The name of the chapter is What is Around Us? So there are so many things which is around us. So textbook, benches, this board, green board, okay, projector. But I am talking about something else. What I am talking about? Can see in this picture. Okay, so what is around us? Let's read the chapter and you will understand the chapter easily. So don't worry. Dhanvi was roaming in the garden with his mother. So now here there is a name of one boy. One boy is roaming in the garden with his mother. Why walking? A question arose in his mind. While walking at that time, means when they are walking, there is one question arose in the mind of Dhanvi. So, Dhanvi asked his mother, what is land made of? Made up of. Now, Dhanvi asked what? What is land made up of? Means, ye prithvi jo hai, wo kis chiz se bani hui hai? Mother replied,
origin means when it is separated. We all know that sun is a big fireball.
See, once again I repeated all four definitions. The first one, when at the process of cool down, the process of cool down of the fireball, see, the element is transformed into solid, it is known as the biosphere. The element which is transformed into liquid, which is known as the hydrosphere. The element which is transformed into the gases, it is known as the atmosphere. And the fact, the living world which developed due to the land, water and air, it is known as the biosphere. So you have to write down about these four spheres, the definition of the four spheres in your notebook. Okay? In this way, the four spheres came into existence on the earth. So our earth is made up with the four spheres. Which four spheres? First is the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. You have to write down all the four spheres definition in your notebook with the good handwriting. So now in this chapter we have to look at about all the four spheres in details. So let's start the first sphere. See here, you can see a very beautiful picture. You can see written atmosphere, biosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere. So see here, the lithosphere means the solid form, okay, which is called lithosphere. Whenever it is water, means it is called hydrosphere. Gases means in the air, it is atmosphere and all of the mixture, water, land and air, it is called biosphere. Okay, so let's start with the lithosphere. The sphere on which we live is known as the lithosphere. The sphere on which means the land, the hard, the solid form, it is known as the lithosphere. So now the actual meaning of lithosphere. So what is the meaning? Litho means rock. Rock means pathar, a big rock, okay, pathar. And sphere means layer. Layer means, as you layer something, ek ke upar ek. So litho means rock and sphere means layer. Means rock, okay, layers. The upper layer of the earth is made of soil and solid materials like rock. Soil means mitti, okay? So the upper layer of the earth is made up with soil and solid materials, okay? Approximately 29% of the surface of the earth is covered with the lithosphere. In the 100%, we all know that 71% is water, and apart from that 29% part of the earth is covered with the lithosphere. Next, this layer is almost 64 kilometer to 100 kilometer thick. So on the land which we are standing, so this land is 64 to 100 kilometers thick. So whenever if we are doing digging, at that time we know so many soil is there. So how much is thick? It is thick like 64 to 100 kilometers. Means we can reach in 100 kilometers more than Ahmedabad, right? So it is a very thick layer. The thickness of the lithosphere is not the same everywhere on the earth. So the thickness of the lithosphere, at some places is 64 kilometers thick, at some places 100 kilometers. So at all the places it is not same, right? Similarly, their interior and exterior do not have indicate physical feature. See, interior and exterior. Interior means at the inner part of the earth, and exterior means at the upper part of the earth, do not have identical physical features. Means all the features are not same. It is mostly made up of substances like soil and rocks. It is mostly made up of. So it is made up of substances like soil and rocks. Those soil and rocks are the basic means inside of the earth, but the pressure of rocks and surface of the earth is equally strong. The surface of earth is also strong and the pressure is also strong. So if the pressure is not strong, then the surface of earth is not be able to survive. Okay, it can be break or it can be not survive, but the surface of the earth is also strong and the pressure is also strong. Thus, balance between the two maintained. So, balance between these two maintained. The pressure of the gases also and the strongness of the thickness of the layer also means of our earth is both are the maintained. So, the crust of the earth does not break. So, because of the maintenance, because of the balance between this, the crust is not break. When the balance between the two is not maintained, the crust breaks and the volcano erupts. But whenever the balance is not maintained, at that time what it is erupts, the crust break and the volcano erupts. Okay. Now there is one question, mommy. How is the lithosphere useful to us? So lithosphere, mommy, can say useful hai. Where can we construct our home if the lithosphere is not there? Without lithosphere, how can we get water to drink, agriculture for food, minerals for industry and forest? So see, if the lithosphere is not there, then how can we survive? Okay, when can we live? Our houses are on the earth. Okay, means it is on the lithosphere. Without this lithosphere, how can we get water to drink? How can we agriculture? Means if we wanted to do the farming, then we have to do on the earth, means on the lithosphere, on the plains. So lithosphere is a very much important for us. So draw picture. Despite all the details you observe in the lithosphere, based on our conversation. So how the lithosphere is important? What is the thickness of lithosphere? What is the inside of the lithosphere? These all the things I already gave you all the details about the lithosphere. So you have to draw a picture as an activity in your notebook for the lithosphere. Okay. So in the next video, we will show the detail about the hydrosphere. So there are four spheres. We completed today the first sphere, and then in the next videos we show about the next sphere. Till that, you have to do what? You have to write down the four definition of the spheres and you have to draw this picture. Okay.